Hare Krishna. If we let our mind devalue our efforts to improve our life, it will end up devaluing our entire life. We often strive to improve ourselves, maybe become more disciplined, become more well-behaved, more sensitive, whatever. But sometimes we may feel, or specifically our mind makes us feel that, oh, there are so many things wrong with me. Even if I improve this, what difference is it going to make? That even if I fix this one thing, so what? And even if I fix it for today, again I'm going to relapse tomorrow. Even if I do it for 5 days, 10 days, after that again I'm going to relapse. So, by making us feel that this doesn't matter, our mind can devalue our efforts to improve our life. But if we listen to the mind, then what will happen? We will stop trying to improve our life. And then, say if we are at this level and we take small steps to move up, little bit, even if for the duration that we stay up, that is good. Even if we relapse, but at least during that time we were up and that was good. But if we don't, then we succumb, we degenerate. The mind will not only not allow us to improve ourselves, the mind will also degrade us, drag us down. And eventually, this doesn't count, that doesn't count. And then finally, life itself does not count. And thus, we end up not valuing anything at all, not valuing our life at all. And that is terrible. That, when that happens, everything is lost. Such people go towards suicide. They may even go towards homicide or genocide. That means if nothing counts, what is the use of improving my life? Why should I live? And if anybody has an improved life, why should they live? Why should anyone live at all? So we have to be very careful not to let ourselves be misled by our minds. And to prevent such misleading, prevent such devaluation, what do we need to do? We need to see ourselves spiritually. Samam pashyan hi sarvatra samavasthitam ishwaram nahinastyatmanatmanam tato yati param gatim. The 13th chapter, Krishna explains in the 29th text that samam pashyan hi sarvatra, when we see that Supreme Lord loves us so much, that Krishna God, despite our efforts, despite our many weaknesses, Krishna is still there with us to help us rise, to help us improve, to help us realize our potential. Then He elevates us. And then when we fix our vision on Him, then we get hope. Our mind may devalue us, but Krishna still values us. And whom are we going to listen, our mind or Krishna? Our mind will only make our life worse, but Krishna can make our life better. So when we start valuing Krishna's words more than our mind's words, then we'll find our mind, our life will become richer, better, sweeter. And ultimately, Krishna will make our life eternally rich, eternally sweet, eternally joyful. Thank you. Hare Krishna.